You so concerned about my real life, and that's alright, but who are you? Just another nigga with a strap. It don't take rocket science to shoot. You don't know shit about getting bricks out, you probably still work true for true. You don't know shit about on your blood, cause you paid your bills with all that loot. How about your baby about to be born and he don't got pampers, wipes, or food? How about your mama fucking your best friend and y'all both just finished school? But it's okay, she thinks it's cool, you're in her way, it's time you move. And you just paid all her damn bills, so you feel like a fool. So what do you suggest I do? You think you know? You got no clue, so please don't tell me what you think I ain't been through.
I don't give a fuck, they don't like me.
Welcome to AJ's Den. Yes, been going on. I didn't record last Friday. I've had to put some more days on my recording. It's because last Friday it was Gay Pride, so I was out there doing the damn thing. Yes. But anyway, let's get on the topic. The topic is now Trump blame. President Obama. That's the crazy part. Now, the reason why I say that's the crazy part is President Obama is the one that put sanctions on Russia before he left out of the office. And Trump tried to take the sanctions away. Not only that a lot of people don't recall, when he was running for president, talking about Trump, when he was running for president, he gave Russia the idea when he said, Russia, if you have any information about those emails, put it out. And all of a sudden, WikiLeaks came out with the email problem. That's when Comey said that they are investigating, that Comey lied and didn't really tell the truth on, well, he didn't even say it. I wouldn't say he lied. He did not say that they was actually doing an investigation on Trump before he was president. But nobody didn't say that. They was talking about Hillary because they did not want a woman. Everybody know it was a sexist. And they didn't want her to come back in there. That, you know what? We didn't have good people who was running for president, really. That's the only reason why Trump got in there. Nobody can't stand this bitch. Nobody. I am not the only African-American. I am not and there's so many Caucasians. I am on every group of, in Facebook that talks about Trump like crazy. And they're mostly Caucasian. So the Trumpets, they can't even grasp it that a lot of people do not like this fucker. He have not done. I asked one Trumpet. He's so into Trump. He said, you should give him a chance. He have did more than President Obama. Okay, name something that he have passed besides the banning. And that was only partial. He did not pass a full banning what he wanted. So name something at least 6 months that this man been president that have passed and benefit the nation. If the health care passed, it is benefiting his friends. It is not benefiting the nation. one percenter. And most of you guys who voted for him are not the one percenter. You electoral college voters are not a one percenter. You are poor. We don't have a fucking middle class anymore. This same man, let me play this because I want this to be played. His lying-ass lawyer sat up there and lied and tried to agree anything what this sucker says, this fucker says, that you guys repeated. Y'all know this motherfucker is a liar. Y'all know he's a liar. And you still constantly supporting this guy. There's a problem. If this was President Obama, you would have tried your best to get his ass out of there. Racism doesn't exist. You're a fucking liar again. It is highly strong and well and kicking. We do not have a melting pot. Just because you see some white women, by the way, they go after athletes. They don't highly date poor men. And you see some white men go after black women. By the way, Muslim black women, they have something. You rarely will see poor white men dating poor black women. You rarely see poor. They're there. I'm not saying they does not exist. They do exist. But if they go out of their culture, any white woman go out of her culture, any Caucasian go out of her culture, she's going to date a highly known athlete who have money. So racism does exist in this country. Highly and strong. Half of you guys wouldn't even have the money if it wasn't on the back of a slave. But you want to just go against every African American. And when something happens, when it interferes or when something happened to you or your family, then you want us to kumbaya your Lord. Fuck you, your Lord. Fuck you and your apologies. I don't give a damn about that. Just like a guy said, Fernando Castro, he deserved to die. And I told him, I hope your family die too, and just like that. And I meant that. Because when you're looking at a video and this man purely assassinated him, that's the problem about Caucasian, because y'all guys see what you want to see. Because you have been programmed to hate African Americans, and by the color of their skin, you don't know nothing about their character. It's crazy. It's really crazy. So let me play this video about Trump accusing President Obama, is crazy, of the Russian meddling. The same one who was running for president said, Russia? If you know anything about the emails, put it out there. 3 days later, it came out. Come on now.
The Trump-Russia investigation, that the true scandal is President Obama not doing enough to stop Russian interference in the election, a claim they're making even though, and this is crucial, the president, President Trump, still maintains, as he did in the campaign, that Russia may not be to blame.
She's saying Russia, 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 but I don't, maybe it was. I mean, it could be Russia, but it could also be China. It could also be lots of other people. It also could be somebody sitting on their bed that weighs 400 pounds, okay?
Ah, yes, the elusive 400-pound
cracker. The
president tweeted this week, quote, the real story is that President Obama did nothing after being informed in August about Russian meddling. An interesting stance, seeing as his own advisors are reportedly struggling to convince him that Russia still poses a threat. His allies are even saying President Obama, not President Trump, should be called to testify before Congress about Russia.
Now, look at this.
Who's in the meetings when you decided to do nothing?
Yes,
there's a big Russian story.
Need to testify. Listen, people, this is bullshit. This man, this little child, I can't even say this man, this little fucking child is fucking ridiculous. This little child up in the White House He want to blame everybody else. Now, I wouldn't be surprised Russia do something, because he might be owe Russia a lot of fucking money. I wouldn't be surprised if they put out stuff to show that this man owe money. Might release his taxes. Who knows? Who cares? And before I get on the three types of Caucasians, I want to talk about the professor who got fired from this university that I will not promote. Said was talking to this Caucasian man, and he was upset because no Caucasians was invited to the Memorial Black Lives Matter event. And she wound up getting fired at that point. So the reason why she got fired is because she said, boo-hoo, boo-hoo. You're upset because you was not invited to the Memorial Black Lives Matter. Guess what? You guys don't invite us to your golf courses. If we get invited, that'll be a miracle. You guys have not allow us to a lot of stuff that I don't give a damn, because I don't want your chitlins. But a lot of African Americans do. So now, because you was not invited to the Black Lives Matter Memorial Day, you have a problem with that. If African Americans decided to speak out, we become racist. And I hate when people are uneducated. Because a African American like myself cannot be a racist. They can only be prejudiced. That's all. They cannot be racist. Like, I don't have power. So go ahead and read your dictionary. Please don't come on here when you are uneducated with me. I just hate talking to uneducated people. So another thing is, I have a little person on here on my Periscope. Now, when I said golf, it was a figure of speech. That's the reason why I can't stand uneducated people. It was a figure of speech. Ignorance is lack of knowledge, and I don't have lack of knowledge, boo. But when I say golf, he brought up Tiger Woods. Let's go back when Tiger Woods was first golfing and was winning. All you saw was a lot of Caucasians took that man through a lot. That I'm not defending Tiger Woods, because he don't even recognize himself as African American. But let's go there. They insulted this guy, said he wasn't nothing. I remember they also said, because after he won the Masters, what you want? Collard greens, chicken, what, a watermelon? What a insult. What a insult. But you tried to portray yourself. Y'all the most of you guys are the most evil fuckers out here. Y'all have done so much to every race. You have become rich off of every race. So This is crazy. I love when they bring up black crime on black crime. Well, if you have witnessed this 400 years from Caucasians killing Caucasians, but you know, they program people on the media that I'm not saying that a lot of African Americans are killing. A lot of African Americans are not killing. It's white on white crime. It's Asian on Asian crime. It's Hispanic on Hispanic crimes. We talked about this. If you're not familiar with my show, don't come on here with that, because I'm trying to be nice before I got that ass. Because you're uneducated when you speak, I'm speaking back to you, and I'm trying to tell you, but most of you, I guarantee you was a Trump voter. If you did not vote for Trump, you might be voted for the other guy because of your uneducated ass. So don't go there. I'm trying not to go there with you because I try to educate my people. I never said that I would take away. I say most Caucasians are the most evil fuck out here. And you are. You have gotten away with your white privileges and everything. I put an example. Trump have done so much, even grab a woman before he was elected by her vagina. And you guys still elected him because you want to do a reconstruction. That little that you know, he is going to hurt the fuck out of you with this insurance. He does not care about you. This is why I say it's called reconstruction. Because they wanted everything what President Obama done to be redone. But they did not know it was going to affect them. How could you expect somebody who was raised, we don't even know if he's a billionaire now, but who was raised with a silver spoon in their mouth to relate to you as a poor person? How could you expect that? On that health bill, it is not given back to our, we tweak Obamacare. That health bill is given back to the rich because they didn't get it in those 8 years. This is what called reconstruction. This is the third time of reconstruction. Why don't you go and read your book about reconstruction? Give you a hint. The first time was Lincoln. Then the Jim Crow law. That, I say it too much. Go ahead and read. See, when white nationalists talk about they want this and they want that and they know no statistics, they have no education, they barely have a high school diploma, they don't want to talk about it. They want to talk about what they think. They don't want to talk about the reading, especially when they talk about the affirmative action. When I tell them and show them who benefit with the affirmative action more than anybody out here, the first thing they will say, you African Americans. A lie. A lie. A lie. Who benefit from the affirmative action is the Caucasian woman. It's not us. And we the one created affirmative action. You guys have benefit off everything that we have created. But somehow you still hate us and you could be poor just like us. I tell you and I tell you again, President Johnson was right, and a Caucasian man who was raised poor. I'll say it again. And then I'm going to get on these three types of Caucasians. He said, you can get, and you can look this up. I want y'all to look it up. He said, you can get an educated black man and put him in front of a Caucasian. And he said, and tell that Caucasian white man that he is better. And I don't care, this educated black man can have a PhD and tell him he's better than that educated black man. And he will believe it. While you whispering and picking his pocket. He will believe it. That's what happened with Trump. Trump told you guys about the Muslim ban. He told you guys about African Americans shooting each other. That you guys killed each other too. But you don't want to talk about that, right? I put that on my YouTube all the time. I show white violence on white violence all the time. Because I'm tired of you lying son of a bitches. Always trying to say that it's only us. You guys have killed each other from day one. You have made treaties with Native Americans and killed them and raped them. Y'all been killing and raping for years. But you don't want to talk about that history. And it's still happening today. But President Johnson said that. And it is so true today. Trump did everything what President Johnson said. And he did it. Trump did it. He's another high Hitler. But you love him because he's a Caucasian man. And it's okay. You know, guys out here know that you are Caucasian. You can accept Trump lying. You can accept Trump from lying. But you could not accept if President Obama did half of the shit that Trump is doing now, he would have been out of there. The Republicans would have got him out of there. They would have impeached him. That it also showed when a African American was running this country, it was peaceful. You see how much of chaos it is now? Our ancestors allowed y'all to come into our neighborhoods, our kingdoms. And you have destroyed what mankind could live peacefully. But you wanted the power so much. You wanted the power so much that you got the power and you're destroying your own people because you're trying to hold on to that power. Now let's talk about the three Caucasians. I don't know if I put it in order. The first ones are the unconscious racists. Those are the dangerous ones. Because they don't even know their race. They are racist. That's the crazy part. They will say, "Oh, I have a black friend." Why do your friend have to be black? Why can't they just be your friend? When their power is being taken away from them. Oh, these ends don't know what they're doing. These black folks don't know why they try to take away. Unconscious. Because they don't understand. They're unconscious. They're unconscious when they voted Trump in. That's one of the Caucasians. Three Caucasians, that's one. An unconscious racist. Man, I want a ban. They're taking our jobs. I want a ban on these Muslims and these Hispanics. What have they done to you? You aren't even supposed to be here. You're European. What have they done to you? They didn't do anything. But you thinking they're taking your jobs. Guess what? They're having a hard time now in California because immigrants was picking a lot of stuff out there. Any fruit or anything like that. So they deported these minorities. They deported these minorities. And guess what? They don't have you guys who saying that y'all, somebody was taking their jobs. They don't have you guys out there trying to get those jobs. Wonder why? Because those not the jobs that you want. That's why they was doing it. You don't want to do hard working and getting paid lower than minimum wage. How dare you sit up there and go against them? Let me go to the second one. White nationalists, racist, the racist ones. Uneducated, don't know no better. Always talking they want their land back. This is not your land. This is not your land. This is not your land. Stop trying to claim something that does not belong to you. That I don't have no love too much for Native Americans, because they're the one that, especially Cherokee and Apaches, they used to take our ancestors back to the slave owner and get paid. They used to rape our, man, we have gone through so much and still surviving. I think about it. We have gone through being raped, killed, and I love when people come on here and say, you're a racist or you're prejudiced. All the shit what your people have done. So when a African American speak out, we either mad, angry, or we are racist. That we cannot be racist, dumbass. We're prejudiced because we're speaking out of the ignorance and the killing and the raping that y'all have done and still doing and getting away with it. Cops are killing, you know, this is that. Let's bring up some statistics. First of all, we are 14% of the population. You guys are the majorities. This is crazy because African Americans on African American crime, that's why I can't stand talking to dumb people, have killed around the world. Now, I looked it up, and it was 500 and something people that African American crime on black on black crime. Guess who have the highest killing of African Americans? Cops have killed more African Americans every year. They kill more African-Americans. White cops have killed more African-Americans than African-Americans on African-Americans. That's something, huh? But I tend to get ignorant folks who do not know the statistics and will not look it up on my show. That's interesting. I cannot stand if you come at me, know your education. It's education, but I got to say education because I study this all the time. I know my history. Most of you white nationalists does not. The second part of racist. First part was unconscious racist. The second part is a racist. That's Caucasians. So, what is the third part? What is the third part? What is the third type of Caucasian? What is it? The one who was raised with us. In the same neighborhood. The one who was raised with us in the same neighborhood will not get pulled over. Will date African-American women until they get out of that area. And then they will say, I don't want to have anything to do with you. I don't want to be reminded that I was raised in the ghetto. And let's get to the ghetto part, because a lot of people are not that intelligent either, because they think when they say ghetto, it's talking about us, African Americans. No. Ghetto means the majority of color people are, when I say color people, not their skin. I'm talking about if it's a majority of Caucasians, that's the ghetto. Is this a majority of Asian? That's the ghetto. If any majority of something, just go and look at it. What ghetto mean? It's just the majority of what race? A lot of you guys put ghetto on us. No, that's not what it is. That's not what ghetto mean. So back to the third Caucasian type of person who was raised in the same place that we was raised in, and when they become higher, they don't know us, know nothing about us. So let's go back. Did they have that attitude when they were in there and dating black women? That's interesting. This is my show. I don't have to answer to you. I am not my ancestors. Oh my God. Do I have to say my poem? Do I have to say my poem? I think I have to say my poem. Do I have to say my poem? Yes, I'm going to say my poem. I am not my ancestors. Nor do I have to answer your questions. I am not my ancestors. You will not disrespect me. I am not my ancestors. I do not want to sit at your table so you can serve me chitlings. I am not my ancestors when you try to treat me like I am nothing. I am not my ancestors. I will not allow you to disrespect me. I will not allow you to trample over me. I am not my ancestors. I am not my ancestors. I will not answer your question. You are not nothing to me. I am from kings and queens. You bow down to me. I am not my ancestors. Do you get that? I am not your slave. I do not want to be your witch. I do not too much care about most, not all, most of you Caucasians. And you know who I'm talking about. So at the end of the day, who gives a damn? You want me to answer your question. I am not a girl. I am a woman. My brothers are not boys. They are men. They are kings. So will I answer your question on here? No, I will not. Bite to the little three Caucasians type, unconscious, racist, and the one who was raised with us. Three types of Caucasians. Now, I do want to go there before I leave out of here. I want to talk about how, because a lot of Caucasians bring up a lot of things, and I want to, before I go there, I want to say to my brothers and sisters, please deprogram yourself. Stop depending on these Caucasians. It's because they want to say, now I'm going into the fourth Caucasian. I just put three, but I'll put the fourth Caucasians up here. The fourth Caucasian want you to depend on them. They want, like, for example, they bring up Chicago, black-on-black crime in Chicago, that they failed to tell. People don't know the reason why crime started. Crime started because the government took away the educational programs. That's why Chance the Rapper is putting money back for the educational program. A lot of people don't know that because they won't study it. They won't study it out at all. They just say, oh yeah, it's a black on black crime, but they don't know why the things start happening. So they goes around and see black on black crime going around in Chicago. And as it going around Chicago, the Caucasian will sit up there and say, we need to, like Trump said, don't let me send more troops in there, cops in there to get y'all under control. Why he say that? It's because they want you to depend on them so they could be your savior, so you can abide by their rules. Get what I'm saying? You didn't miss the savior part. I hope not. They want you to be their savior. Caucasian. Most of the Caucasians want African Americans depend on you. This is where I'm telling you, stop depending on Caucasians. Get your shit right. Stop worrying about you and your people. Stop doing the thing, because that's what they want you to do. They want you to depend on them with welfare. They want you to depend on them with all kinds of subsidies. Start getting your shit right. Stop depending on them, because that's what they want you to do. They want to be your savior. See? Them black folks they can't exist without us. They can't exist without us. So we have to be their savior. That's why we had them enslaved. Because they can't do nothing. We whip them like children. Because they're kids. That's why we call them boy and girl. They want you to be the saviors. See, we were trying to tell you, but Lincoln didn't hear us. They're supposed to be our slaves. They're supposed to be our boys. We rape them when we want to. It's not rape. This is our property. We take it with us. That's our property. That's why they say the things they say. That's our property. We can rape. We can do whatever. Long as we are their savior. They're eating well. They're dressed well. So we can do whatever they want. What we want. Because we are their saviors. That's what they want you to believe. So what I'm saying is, stop depending on subsidies. Stop depending on food stamps. Because most of these Caucasians want you to depend on them. They want to be your savior. That's the fourth Caucasian. The savior. Start thinking. Start going to a library, getting your education. That's one thing Caucasians hate, is an educated African American. That's why they hated President Obama. He was the best president in history of time. How can a man come in, and how quick Caucasians have forgotten that Bush left this country into almost going into a Great Depression. President Obama, he wasn't, let me clear this up. It's a lot of stuff that he did that I did not respect him on. But most of the stuff, he took us out of a Great Depression from a 10% unemployment rate and took it down to 4.4%. Now look, Trump only been in six months. When he received the presidential White House when he became the president, it was going down 4.3. Guess what? The unemployment rate is rising again. Why? Because he wants to do the reconstruction so bad that what President Obama put in play that helped this country, he is undoing. So we are going to go back. We're going to go back to what Bush left. So when the Great Depression, and we're going to get in history on this before I go. When the Great, let's go to the first Great Depression. See, Roosevelt saw and had to deal with the Great Depression. And when he dealt with the Great Depression, he told the rich. See, Trump is looking at, oh, I can help my people on this health care. I'm talking about helping his people. The one percenter that we don't even know his ass is rich because he won't show his taxes. So he's thinking about if we pass that health care, he's helping his one percenter. Now, if they keep on getting richer, it's going to be a Great Depression. President Roosevelt had to tell the rich when the Great Depression was going on, listen, you got to share with these people, because if the middle class, the poor spend, buy your product, that means that you get money. But if they don't have no money to spend or buy your product, you're not gonna get richer. So you have to share. It's just a prime example. Read your history. See, they have gotten so comfortable of having people on the bottom, the rich, that they never experienced what Roosevelt had to experience, why he had to talk to the rich. That's because they never read their history. Never read their history at all. And the crazy thing about the situation is they're not going to read their history. They don't want to know anything about their history because they're thinking it's not going to happen today. It's sad because it's going to hurt America, Trump. Trump is drying out America. You can see why he went bankrupt. The 8 years President Obama was in office, he has surpassed the spending of travel. Just travel. President Obama in those 8 years. He ought to been here for 6 months. So you can really see how he went bankrupt. He filed those bankruptcies because of the spending. He never had to answer to nobody. That's why he made the comment, my life was pretty good before I became president. This is pretty hard. Very, very. His vocabulary, his education is zero. Beyond. It is crazy how this man got into office. He really think that he's on Apprentice. I always ask the question, I asked this question at the beginning of my show. Why you keep on coming down here? Why do you guys, most of you Caucasians, think that this man can relate to you? I know one thing. A lot of the cops that are killing my brothers and sisters really is really asking for a civil war. You're really asking for a civil war. Keep doing what you're doing, and a civil war is going to come. If you really think that you can do all the things and do not get a conviction, you are sadly mistaken. It's going to happen. And I know you guys think that we're just going to sit back and we're just going to let these things go like our ancestors. I'm willing to die for my cause. Are you? I'm not going to sit up here and allow you to do whatever you want to do. And you did it. And think that you also, not only that, you think you could just apologize. And that's okay. We're going to accept your apologies. We're going to accept your apologies. We're not going to accept your apology anymore. And I'm not the only one feel that way. I'm not the only one that feel that way. You either come together and realize who you're fucking with, or you come together and you die. That's how I feel. Bye.
Broken glass everywhere. People on the stage, you know they just don't care. I can't take the smell, can't take the noise. Got no money to move out, I guess I got no choice. Rats in the front room, roaches in the back. Junkies in the alley with the baseball bat. I tried to get away, but I couldn't get far, cause a man with a touch of repossessed my car. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a trouble sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep on going under. Standing on the front stoop, hanging out the window, watching all the cars go by, roaring as the breezes blow. A crazy lady living in a bag, eating out of garbage pails, used to be a fag hag. Such a that's the tangle, skipped the life and dangle. A sitcom princess seemed to lost her senses. Down at the peep show, watching all the creeps, so she could tell her stories to the girls back home. She went to the city and got so did it. She had to get a pimp, she couldn't make it on her own. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head.
It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep on going under.
Hey!
It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder
how I keep on going under.